in. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, guys? Craft Farms here with another video, and today we are back on Dad's Farm V2. So I just finished rolling moisture onto all of the soybean fields, and cultivation tillage is also finished for the year. So what we're going to do is we are going to fast forward time to tomorrow to engage soil mod. And then what we're going to do is we need to get these guys rolling. We need to get these back to the farm. And get them ready to be washed up whenever we wash stuff. We're going to do that. We'll take these guys to the farm. Quick screenshot there. So as you guys can see, I'm running up at 40 frames a second. For whatever reason, these cultivators, whenever they were running, were giving me lag. I don't know what the deal is with that. Maybe it's a mod conflict or something. Never had that issue before until now, so that's kind of an annoying issue. But yeah. So, we are done with that. So what we're going to be doing this episode is planting. I did not get a tender converted over, but the reason I didn't do that is because I remembered that I have a different tender, and I will show you guys that here in just a moment, once we park these guys at the farm. Now, I'm not going to wash them yet, I'm going to wait and wash all of our spring equipment right before harvest. So this is just going to sit up by the fertilizer spreader until harvest rolls around. And also, if you guys see, we are $30,000 in the negative. That's because we've had to pay a lot of maintenance because of all of the equipment that we have. Plus, having to pay for the chemical, so that's not been a help either. So we're going to stop that guy. I meant to hit right shift F instead of control F, but... Alright, and then we'll take this guy and park him up here as well. We can sneak back in here. See if we can sneak around this without hitting this stuff too much. So we make even a little bit, though. We probably would have hit the sprayer there, but alright, I guess. So yeah, like I said, what we're going to be doing in this episode is planting. So we got the planter out. We got the sprayer and truck sitting here because after planting, we'll be putting down another round of herbicides. So this growth cycle, what we need to do is plant, roll that ground, and spray the second herbicide on the wheat. So we are going to plant, and what we're going to do is we are going to rent a tender. And it is in Winston's category, the GMC fertilizer seed truck. So we should only need it for 2 hours, maybe. So we will hop on over to it. Put it in group 7. So yeah, this is the GMC fertilizer truck that Winston did. I don't know of anywhere that you can get this anymore. I don't believe that it is public anymore anyways. So now we gotta find out if there's a place to buy seed. I'm gonna guess that it is right over here at those bins. Either that seed or fertilizer, I'm not sure. Guess we will find out. Let's bring this up, maybe I'll say. Refill. Yes, seeds. There we go. That's exactly what we want. So yeah, guys, this is the last video that you guys are going to have for a little while. The reason for that is I am going to Farmers Union Camp 2 days from when you see this video. This is actually, today is Wednesday, and I'm recording it just because I will not have a chance to record video until like Sunday, so this needs to go up Saturday. So yeah, that is why I'm recording it so early. So yeah, I leave on Monday and I'll come back Friday, but I'm going to my dad's right away, and I will not be taking my laptop with me because that will be a major pain to take care of. And what we're also going to do is we are going to rent this cedar for 1 hour. And then we need a tractor to pull it. It requires 180 horsepower, so still larger, not that large. So we'll go with this guy for an hour. And the reason we need this guy is because I'm going to be planting grass in a couple of spots here. And so I'm going to just use this. That button. Grass. There we go. So yeah, we're going to plant this little section in grass, and then there's a little section there that I'm also going to put into grass. Which means that whenever I do another... Well, see, I think the only course that I have for field one here is field one, right? Is the 26-23. So we'll just delete that course because I will have to redo it as well as recalculate the field edge path. It's kind of cool how you can lower this thing without unfolding it. Raise up. Yeah, we will get this little section planted here. So I'm going to start on this little bit. Whoa, kind of jackknife in there. Alright, so we need that. I want to turn off my offset. I want to shift this over as far as I can. Right about there should do it. So I'm just going to do this little section here just so that way I don't hit it with the air seeder. And then I'll just hire a worker or something for that other section. This little spot won't take too long. And then I think what I'll do is I'll just put courseplay to planting that other section, and then I can just go back with this and fix its skips, because I know that it will have skips. Because that's how courseplay is. But I'll take courseplay's skips because it is a very, very useful script. Don't know what I did without it. That's for sure. Wow, this thing gets dirty really fast. It's crazy. Can't go that way. I'm gonna hit that house. So yeah, this should be a pretty quick job so far. We will get started on the wheat. I can tell that I missed a little snippet there. I mean, it's not terrible if I miss stuff. I just would rather not, because with it going into grass, I don't want field in there. Last little strip, and then we will put courseplay onto seeding the other section. This is a 6 meter drill. So we'll have to record do a field edge for this. Let's do it as like 26 or something, just to make sure that's nothing that we have. 6 meters. We want to start it up in the north, east, head south. A couple headlands. There we go. So now we'll turn around and get it seeding. Off. All right, so he can do that, and we are going to head out with the air seeder here and go plant us some wheat. See, so I want to change this over to wheat. There we go. Our nice shiny 9620R and air seeder won't be nice and shiny for very long though. Yeah, as always. So this monster almost takes up the entire road, which is kind of fun. That's how most equipment is. Usually takes up majority of the road. We want to take right here. We got a lot of seeding ahead of us as well, and a lot more spraying, and then also some more rolling. Now the land roller is sitting back there until I finish planting, because once I finish planting, then I will go back to the roller and roll all of the corn ground, and then I will then after that it'll be planting and spraying the soybeans, and then planting and spraying corn, and then it'll be harvest. It'll be pretty busy. Hopefully we have a good yielding harvest, because we can definitely use the money, especially if we want to get into beef, because we need extra money to buy that equipment. Luckily, we don't have a loan out right now, so we don't have to. So A, we don't have to worry about paying a loan, and B, we can take out a loan for beef machinery if we have to. I'm hoping that we don't end up needing to take out a loan, but we may end up having to. Not positive. So what I'm going to do is just plant all four of these fields in one shot. So I will just do a headland straight across and then go up and down, same as I have been lately. I know it's not the most realistic way of doing it, but it's a lot faster, I guess you could say. I have thought about just combining all these fields, you know, like fields 1 through 4 that are in one spot, you know, 7 or 5 through 8, 9 and 10, 11, 12, 13, 15, 16, all those fields that are really close to each other. I have thought about just combining them all together in Giant's Editor, or even, I guess, in-game would work too. Set up, offset, shift that over to about there. We want to hop into our tender truck. Oops, that's right, put it in group 7. Holy smokes, that guy's missing a lot. That's ridiculous. Oh well. Just gonna have to go back and fix it, I guess. Technically, this auger isn't really high enough for this, but it'll do. Oh, jeez. Hopefully I can use this. I don't think that it has a... Oh, there we go. Start overloading. So let's just back it up as far as we can. And press O. Hop back in this guy here. Watch for it. So I think I want to put on some extra weight. Steering this down. Alright, we are filled up and ready to rock. Let's drop this down. Guess I need to pull the truck ahead. Get him out of the way. Yeah, this is a very well done truck. Alright, so this guy is probably going to hit that tree. Nope. Good. Alright, so let's get seeding. Whoa, this thing is way off. That's better. 14.1, what's it say in the shop? Oh yeah, it is 14 meters. Okay, cool. There we go. We are seeding. Yep, we're seeding all the way over. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. And we'll get our... whatchamacallit, cruise set. We're gonna run 15 miles an hour. I don't think this is at all realistic, but I could be wrong. But I'm quite sure that it is not at all realistic to run this fast with an air seeder. But I would not know. I've never been in an air seeder before, so Don't need an air seeder with hay, so. Probably for this map should have gotten the larger air seeder, I guess, but this one will work for the time. Yeah, two headlands will be plenty. I don't know what the heck just happened there. That was strange. Okay. It's the lovely farming simulator physics kicking in again, evidently. Would love to take this air seeder and put it in Blender and give it more of a John Deere green, you know, like, this is a John Deere green. This really is not, it's just a dark green. The auger's a different kind of a green, and just give it better textures, and give it better dirt as well, and then give it different functions. I'd like to strip the auger to run off mouse controls so you can actually like move it. I think that'd be really cool. That'd be a project for me too, because I've never actually dealt with mouse control things before. Got to start somewhere, I guess. So yeah, you guys, you won't have a video next week, Tuesday, Thursday, or Saturday. Because like I said, going with camp, I'm not going to take my laptop. So, you know, one, wouldn't even have time to use it at camp. Two, you know, to use it afterwards, I wouldn't have time either. So, it'd be kind of pointless. So we'll go here and do the headland here by the farm. Along this farm's trees. Move our GPS line again. Shift it over some more. Do it. Put the air seeder down. So we can start seeding right there. About as good of a spot as any. Our Puma is done, but it's not ready to go back to the dealership yet. Once I finish this video, I will go back and fix it, little skips, and then return it to the dealer. I'll owe them a little more money because I'm going to return it dirty because I don't have time to drive it all the way to the farm, clean it, and drive it all the way back. So they're going to have to wash it for us. But it's just another $100 or so, I think it is, for dirty equipment. Let's move back up here a little bit and catch little sliver. Wow. I am terrible at backing up an air seeder. But something like this, even in real life, I think would be a lot harder to back up because you've got so many pivoting points. That you would most likely run into issues of jackknifing it. Jackknifing it and that kind of stuff. Now we'll go ahead and plant a strip. We'll flip this 90 degrees and go over to here. Should probably lift that. And then we'll go over to here. And we're gonna do a strip going down. Okay, let's move this over again. There we go. Get going on this course. Kick the cruise control on. Head on down. Yeah, we should have a pretty bountiful harvest. We have a soil pH of 6.8, and moisture has actually gone down quite a bit. That kind of sucks. The moisture should be about 70, but it's only in like the 40 to 50 range. Pretty sure I rolled this field, these fields. I could be wrong, I guess. Now we have an N of 9 and a PK of 4. We have very little weeds, and we'll be putting down extra herbicide to prevent the weeds even further for another 3 days, which should give us enough time to get up to harvest and have weed-free harvest. So yeah, I sat and calculated it while I was running the long passes with the land roller. I sat and calculated how much land is on here, and it is just under 252 hectares. It's about, I think it was 670-some acres on here. So it's actually a relatively decent-sized map. My map is, at the moment, even about 3 times that. Or maybe not quite yet, but it's going to be quite a lot larger than that. I think that we need to go just a little bit further. I'd rather have a little bit of overlapping versus stuff that I missed. And we will do our last end row here. Our last section of Andrews, and then we will go back to going up and down and get this field, these fields knocked out. I think we can actually do some in-cab work here. I don't usually do much in-cab work on camera. I try and do as much as I can, but for you guys it gets pretty boring, I think. Do you guys know what those exactly are, what the purpose of them is? Let me know down below, because I have no idea what the heck those are, or what their purpose is. It's quite strange looking to me. Again, I've never seen a tractor like this, either. Everything we run is old. Got like 1086 internationals, 2290 cases, 4430, 5020 John Deere, and we have a 5488. I have a Deutz tractor. Whole bunch of different kinds of machines. Let's see what we got. Oh, we're just about done. Actually, I will stop this timer and I will get my outro going. So, yeah, with the N levels, about 5 is where you're the best at. So we're at 9, so we're going to have about an 80% yield. Actually, I want to do that, so that way he doesn't run. 4, that's perfect PK level, so we are good there. 6.6, 6.8, that's going to put us maybe about 98 to 100%, so that's going to help our yield very, very well. Moisture should be in the 50s. I don't know why I was reading this backwards. Like 100%, what, like 57% you'd have to have 100% or something like that. 100% moisture would be too much. So 57% moisture. So we're about pretty good. So we should have a very, very good yield from our harvest. So, guys, that is going to be it for this video. I will get as much of this planting done as I can. I'm actually going to be going to the state fair in 2 days. So I'm going to be leaving tomorrow night to get ready for that, because we are planning to leave very early in the morning. So then we will be able to... Actually, I think I might want my thing. Whatever. Anyways, so yeah, guys, that's going to be all for this video. The next video, we will be... We'll either be spraying this ground, or we'll be planting corn. Soybeans. One of those two. Not sure which one we'll be doing. But we'll find out when we get there. Gotten a lot of comments about the truck and the beef, and it looks like we're going to be doing beef. Looks like we're going to be sticking to the 9620R as well. And then for a truck, I've gotten a lot of the Chevy and then a few of the Ford, so we'll see. Maybe what we'll do is we'll sell the Duramax that we have and then buy the Chevy and one of the Fords. And then kind of incorporate both. But neither of those will be happening until after harvest, obviously, because we are $60,000 in debt. Whoa. But, yeah. So, that's going to be all for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. As always, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the tutorial video that I did. Well, for me it's today, but for you guys it's on Wednesday. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that tutorial video. It's a bunch of Blender stuff. How to recalculate faces, and add some modifiers, do some textures, all that good stuff. So make sure you guys check out the other videos. Make sure that you subscribe if you have not already. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central and Saturdays at noon Central. And check out down below in the description for my PC specs, links to my social medias, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thank you guys for watching, and until next time, I will see you.